Hello everyone and welcome back to another super easy PowerPoint animation tutorial, which is inspired by the work of Andrew Wang. You can watch many more interesting animations on his website and the link is given in the video description. Let's get started and learn how to reanimate this in PowerPoint using the shapes and spin animation effect. There are three different methods you can use to draw this partial circle in PowerPoint. The first is to simply use the partial circle shape from the shapes drop-down menu. The second method is to insert an oval shape, and then insert a rectangle shape and place it on top of the oval. Then adjust the position and size of the rectangle. To change the fill and outline color of the rectangle shape to match the slide color. Like, if you have a white slide background, then have the same fill and outline color for the rectangle. And if you are using any other color, then apply the same color to the rectangle shape. Later, group both shapes from the Shape Format tab. The third method is to draw an oval and then a rectangle on top. Set the position and size of the rectangle and then use the Merge Shapes, Subtract command from the Shape Format tab. Now it's time to apply the spin animation effect to the shape. Select the shape and then go to the Animations tab. Click the Add Animations drop-down menu, and then choose Spin from the Emphasis Animation Effect list. If you are going to use the second method to draw the partial circle, then you might face a problem after applying the spin effect to it, and that could be the non-circular rotation of the shape. That is because we have grouped two shapes together and that changed the anchor point of the shape. If you select this shape, then you can notice that the anchor point is not in the middle and center of the shape. If you select the oval shape within the group, then you can notice where the exact anchor point should be. But because we grouped two shapes together, it changed the anchor point. In any case, if you need to use the grouped shapes with the spin effect, then there is a workaround to this problem. Draw another oval shape, which should be a bit larger than both shapes, and both shapes should fall under that oval. Now, group all the three shapes together and later remove the fill and outline color of the larger oval to hide it. If you will not apply the spin effect to this shape, then it will rotate in perfect circular order. If you are going to use the third method of using merge shapes, subtract command, then there will be no problem applying the spin effect to it, as the anchor point will remain in the middle and center of the shape. So, after applying the spin effect to the shape, we need to configure the effect options properties by double-clicking the effect from the animation pane. Set the amount of rotation to quarter spin or 90 degrees clockwise. If you want, then you can also apply the start and end smoothness. Then move to the timings tab and change the start type from on-click to with previous. Set the time duration to very fast, and that is 0.50 seconds, and then apply the changes. Now, we need to apply the spin effect to the same shape three more times. So, we will repeat the same steps. Select the shape, click the Add Animations drop-down menu, and then apply the spin effect again. Set the start type to with previous and change the duration to 0.50 seconds. This time, also add a delay timing of 0.75 seconds to the second spin effect to have a delay of 0.25 seconds between both spin effects. Double-click the effect and change the amount to quarter spin. Repeat the same steps to apply the spin effect the third time. For the third spin effect, the delay timing will be 1.50 seconds and the rest of the effect options will remain the same. Apply the spin effect one last time, so our partial circle may complete a full 360 degrees rotation, and for the fourth spin effect the delay timing will be 2.25 seconds. The rest of the effect options will remain the same as we configured for the previous spin effects. See the slideshow, and the partial circle will start spinning 90 degrees clockwise while having a pause of 0.25 seconds between each of the four spins, and will complete full 360 degrees rotation. Once we have one shape ready with the animation effects, it's time to replicate it over the slide. The easiest way to replicate an object in PowerPoint is to select the object and then hold down the Shift and Control keys. Then drag and drop the object to the position you like. After that, start tapping the F4 key to create more replicates. It will save you time and all the shapes will have the same distance between them. Before you start creating more duplicates downwards, first change the rotation of the few shapes by using the Rotate drop-down menu from the Shape Format tab. Now, select all the shapes and then drag and drop them downwards while holding the Shift and Control keys. Then start tapping the F4 key to create more duplicates. Finally, you can select one of the shape rows and then change the direction to counterclockwise from the Effect Options drop-down menu. Do the same to change the direction of each of the odd or even rows. See the slideshow, and there you have one loop of the animation ready. To make this animation infinite, go to the Slideshow tab, and then click Setup Slideshow. Here makes a checkmark on the option, Loop continuously until the Escape key is pressed. From the Transition tab, set the Advanced Slide Timing to 3 seconds while unchecking the On Mouse Click option. Run the slideshow, and there you have an infinite loop of the animation. If you are using Office 365, then you can create an infinite animated GIF of this animation by clicking on the File menu's Export option. So, I hope you might have learned something new and interesting, which will help you in your other PowerPoint projects. Let me know your thoughts by liking, sharing, and commenting on this. You can also subscribe to our channel and can turn on the bell notification to stay updated on our next tutorials. Thanks a lot for watching the video tutorial. Bye and take care.